Who was that?
Thank you.
Huh? Men coming!
I see you running around.
What the hell's he doing? Running around like that? Shit! Holy shit!
That's the last of them. Jesus, Cove, how many men have you pissed off? All right. This has got to be the generator, but it's been shot to hell. Okay. That should do it. There we go.
Drop it!
If you had bullets, I wouldn't be breathing now, would I?
Please, mister.
I don't shoot women if I have a choice. Do I have a choice?
I ain't got nothing. I got nowhere to go!
All right, let's see if they got an underground bunker around here. Bunker, yes. Here it is. Hey, this is handy. A map. All marked up. Yeah, nice. guess they won't be needing it. Not anymore.
Deke, you there? It's probably nothing. You sounded like bike engines, riding somewhere on the mountain.
I just finished clearing the radio tower for Copeland. I'm gonna climb the tower, see if I can see anything.
Deke, you okay? You don't sound like yourself.
It's nothing. You know, I just let this drifter get the drop on me. Lucky for me, she was out of ammo.
You let her go, didn't you?
Okay. Yeah, fuck. Yes, I let her go.
One of these days, Deke, that code of yours is gonna get you killed.
Yeah, well, something's gonna do it, right? Does it matter what? Deacon out. Jesus, what a climb. All right, let's see what the hell Boozer's talking about. We're right. Someone's on the mountain. I see smoke from their campfire.
Son of a bitch. You knew I heard something. Where are they? I'm gonna head out there.
No. God damn it, Boozer. Gotta get your arm healed up so we can ride the hell out of here. I'll take care of him. Try to stay awake in case they head your way. Deacon out. Oh, Jesus. I gotta get in shape. Almost there. Yeah, come on, keep going. Almost there. Oh, shit's killing me. More scrap. Could make something out of this. Can of fuel. Oh, here we go. Done. St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down. I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. Hang on, see the value in St. John. But bringing back Morgan is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
I'll cope. The only thing keeping us from turning into savages is about 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're wrong about that. Copeland out.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done?
Boozman, you awake? I'm, heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. Might be an ambush camp?
Find out when I get there. Deacon out!
Got your radio on? I got bored. Figured I'd see if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Oh, Boozer, that's amazing. Yeah, I do need some. Deacon, Booze man, you were right. They set up along the railroad tracks.
Kill every one of the sons of bitches.
That was kind of the plan. Deacon out.
Thank you.
Shit, almost out.
I get down. No, freakers.
Get down.
Freaks.
Finally.
ammo.
Here you are. For the love of Christ!
That's the last of them. Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain. Yes. Boozer. It's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke, I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Shit. Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out.
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride.
North. Yeah.
Man, no. No, I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke, it means a lot to me.
Take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out. Mass grave. I keep forgetting it's so close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how.
Deke! Oh, God damn it. I'm sick and tired of drifters coming in my camp, killing folk like we were out in the shit.
What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Manny said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man, then radio me. We'll fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find him.
Deke, you there? I was thinking about heading down to that logging camp, clear out those nests. And I see more freaks up here.
Boozer, no. No, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the nests, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight. Maybe fewer freaks inside those nests. Or take them out while it's still light out. There'll be more of them, but they won't be as strong.
Deke, you there? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Oh, booze man. Yes, yes. I always need more shit. Thanks, brother. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Who remembers the skid rows of this great country? People live on the streets in boxes and tents. Because they couldn't afford the American dream. Some of those good people fought for this very country, only to have the feds forget about it as soon as they were done with it. PTSD doesn't stand for post-traumatic stress disorder. It stands for put them soldiers down. Well, we're all homeless now, living in the wilderness in the way of our forebears. The feds used to think we needed their welfare and handouts to survive. We showed them how wrong they were. What we need now is a strong will, determination, and trust in each other. The feds were never gonna give us that. And you? You want our trust? You gotta earn it.
Here we go.
This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
That's great. That's great. Radio Free Oregon is on the air once again. Oh, Jesus, what have I done? Good.
That's right. I gotta finish burning out this infestation zone.
gotta be close to a nest. Whew, I can smell it. Another nest. Burn it down. Here we go. It never gets old. Needed this. That's it.
I gotta clear them out. I gotta make it safer to ride through here.
Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? This is it.
All right. What have we got?
Maybe in one of these.
Got it.
chopper? Wait, what are you talking about?
Near a chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Well, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Careful. Don't get too close to them. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hold on, hold on. They're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Even my turn on the tuning roster.
Blame the CEO. Or the
with.
Stay in the shrubs. They can't see me in there.
How much longer do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? We'll bug out when the dock's finished.
What time is it?
What's wrong with your suits?
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
It's nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Then what, they're
sleeping like babies?
No, no, no.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my body apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was foobar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
See the caves? Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Wonder how long this will take.
Too damn long. Not that long.
Bushes. I gotta keep to the bushes.
Anyone else hear that?
Yeah.
I heard something.
Thank you.
Boozer, you there? Booze man, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
We rode out of farewell. The Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living in hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. I broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they'd have blown it to hell. Just so we wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon. Hmm.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real.
I'll come back later. Finish burning down these nests.
And I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of it. They've been lying and wait all this time. Till they crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them, thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus, Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit! You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Well, except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy.
Mass grave. Why'd they bury this shit out here again?
Oh, yeah, because they're assholes.
Mobile medical unit. Oh, I gotta find a way inside. See if there's another injector.
There's the generator. Here we go. Never gets old.
Oh, God damn it. Fuse blown.
Needed this. Done. Okay, let's see. What's going on here?
Oh, where the hell am I gonna get a fuse?
Wait, no, not this way.
Gotta take a closer look.
Gotcha.
Feels, yes.
Now we're in business. I'll let you do it.
Bring them all down on me. That's all of them. Yeah.
Yeah.
Checkpoints, waiting to die. An ejector. Nero had all the good shit. Better living through chemistry. I gotta burn them out. I gotta make it safer to ride. Come back later and finish burning out these nests.